Welcome to our patient education video on proximal humerus fractures, brought to you by Adelaide Shoulder and Upper Limb Clinic. I'm Dr. Oscar Brumby-Rendell, an upper limb orthopaedic surgeon, and I'm here to guide you through understanding proximal humerus fractures, their treatment options, and the rehabilitation process. Proximal humerus fractures occur at the top of your arm bone, near the shoulder. They can happen to anyone, but are more common in older adults due to factors like osteoporosis. These fractures come in different types, including two-part, three-part, and four-part fractures. The classification depends on how many parts of the bone are broken and the severity of the injury. Sometimes the shoulder is also dislocated as part of the fracture, called a fracture dislocation injury. In less severe cases, non-operative treatment with a sling will be recommended. This helps support the arm and allows the bone to heal naturally. Patients will typically wear the sling for 6 weeks and will move the shoulder as their pain and comfort allows. For more complex fractures, a surgical intervention might be necessary. This can involve using plates and screws, a procedure where the broken parts of the bone are repositioned and held together with the metal plate and screws. A small incision at the front of the shoulder is used to go between the muscles to get access to the broken bones. Once the bones are back in better position, an intraoperative x-ray is used to confirm appropriate metal wear and fracture positioning. In cases of severe damage, a procedure called reverse shoulder replacement might be required. This is done when the bones are too badly damaged to repair and will have a better outcome with a joint replacement. This can allow a quicker recovery and has become a much more common treatment as shoulder joint replacement technology has improved. After treatment, rehabilitation plays a crucial role in the recovery process. After surgery, proper wound care and pain management are essential. You'll be advised on how to use slings and the early shoulder exercises to support the healing process. Physical therapy will be tailored to your specific case, focusing on exercises to regain strength and mobility in your shoulder. A physio will usually see you the day after surgery in the hospital to guide you through the exercises during the first 2 weeks. After this, we encourage you to attend your local physiotherapist of choice, and we will provide you with a personalized rehabilitation plan to give to your physiotherapist. There are generally two phases of your rehabilitation. The first 6 weeks concentrates on moving your arm as you can tolerate, going slow whilst we wait for your shoulder to heal. The next 6 weeks is where it is stepped up and your physiotherapist will guide you through some specific range of motion exercises and some early strengthening. And after 12 weeks postoperatively, you'll have lifting of all restrictions and can start using your shoulder normally.
This presentation forms part of the Adelaide Shoulder and Upper Limb Clinic's online educational series. If you would like to view more of our online education materials, please visit our website, asulc.com.au.